Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Kimberly Margarita and I enjoy painting my face. Today I wanted to go through some of my favorite face and body painting products for you guys because I get quite a lot of questions what kind of things I use when I am doing more creative style makeups. So yeah, we're just gonna be kind of going through a couple different products today. So we're just gonna jump right into it. And if you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below so you don't miss out on future videos. And yeah, we're just gonna jump right into it. So I get a lot of questions what white base I use in some of my makeups. And my all-time favorite white base is the Color White from Makeup Forever. So this is a cream white paint. I really, really prefer using cream whites as opposed to water activated paints, just because I find the water activated white paint can get quite streaky. And you have to really layer it a lot and then it can kind of crack. So I really, really like using a cream. And this cream paint from Makeup Forever is super white and thick and opaque. So you can really pack it on and get a super opaque white base. So when I use this stuff, I will stipple it on, or I will pack it on with a dense foundation brush, and then I will go over top of it with a powder. And the powder I always use for a white base is the MAC Studio Fix powder in Shivering White. So this is just a stark white powder. And I really like to set my entire face after going in with the cream paint. Since this is a cream, it can be quite creasy, so yeah, setting it with a powder is a must. You can also do a translucent powder, but I really like the white powder because it helps the white base look even more white. Now for cream paints, another cream product that I really like is the Makeup Forever Color Sticks. So this is a face and body color grease paint. So again, it is a cream, but these go on like this is, oh, they're so creamy and they blend out really, really nicely. So for instance, I like to use these a lot of the times when I'm doing colored contouring. So say I have like a white base down and then I'll go in and layer these on top with a brush and then I'll just buff it out and they blend so nicely. So this blue one is M204. These are a couple of my favorites. This purple one is M900. This is just like a perfect purple shade. And these come in all different colors, by the way. And then this orange one is M706. So as you can see, they are so bright and so opaque, and they just blend out like a dream. My usual method for body painting is I like to go in with creams first, and then for more of the detailed work, I like to go in with a water-activated paint or like a MAC acrylic paint. So yeah, I always start off with a layer of cream paint. And also by using cream paint, if you're gonna go over top of that with eyeshadows, it's gonna really help them pop and it's also gonna give them something to stick to, like if you're gonna contour with eyeshadows, so. Now, these are a couple of water activated paints. These are Chroma Cakes from MAC. These come in amazing colors and I like to use these, as I said before, for more detailed work after we already have the cream down. I love these for more detailed work. A couple other water activated paints that I love, as you can see, this is very well used. This is a palette from Mayron and they make these paradise paints. So yeah, these are all aqua paint, so they're all water activated. This is the Paradise palette in pastel. I've actually had this since I was in makeup school. This thing has lasted me years and I still have quite a bit left, so I love using these. I have a couple other ones too, but the pastel one is my favorite. Another product that I had to mention is these Hydra liners from Suka Beauty. Again, they are water activated. They come in a couple different variations. So they have some UV activated paints and these are so crazy bright. These also work amazing for eyeliner too. They just have really unique shades and these are super, super pigmented. I'll do a couple swatches for you guys. And I love using these for more detailed stuff. So, oops, this one is Grape Soda. And then this This was such an awkward place for me to swatch. Don't mind my hairy armpits, by the way. This one is Blue Steel. And then another favorite of mine is Bubblegum. Oh my gosh, why did I swatch it like this? So yeah, these are a well-loved product by me. So you should definitely check out Suva Beauty. Another one of my absolute favorite products for more detailed work is the acrylic paints from MAC. These are such an incredible paint because they are so thick and very, very opaque, and they dry to a nice matte finish. They don't really crumble off. They're just great quality. I can't say enough good about these guys. There are a couple shades that aren't safe around the eye area. I believe it's like the more red tone shades. So maybe just double check on that before you go ahead and use these around the eye area because they can stain. Yeah, I love using these for body and face painting. Sometimes I will even use them on the lips. And yeah, they're just a super opaque paint and very true to the color in the bottle. And they're really easy to mix too, so you can basically create any shade with these guys. I love them. Another one of my favorites from Makeup Forever is the color inks. They came out with these guys not too long ago, and these are amazing. They are a super versatile product. Again, they are really easy to mix, so you can create any color. They have a couple different finishes. They have a few metallic ones, and then the rest are just a nice matte paint. They dry down to a nice matte finish. They blend out really, really nicely. For a lot of my body painting looks, I will use these on the lips because you can create any lip color. They dry down nicely, they wear it nicely, they don't crack, and yeah, I can't say enough good about these things. The only thing I would be careful about is the fuchsia one. I used this on my eye area and it did stain pretty badly, so just be wary of this color. But all the other ones I haven't had a problem with. You just have to make sure to really give them a good shake. And for face paints that are a little bit more expensive, I would recommend getting the primary colors, like a red, blue, and a yellow, because with those three colors, you can create any shade that you like. So that's always a good idea instead of buying every single color, since the price can add up quite quickly that way. It's always a good idea to go with the basic primary colors, and then, like I said, you can create any shade you want. And I will quickly just do a couple swatches of these guys, so you can see how intense the color is. Oops, that was a bit much. This is my favorite one. This is in the shade M204. It's just a gorgeous, like, seafoam green turquoise shade. So this is by far my most used. I also absolutely love their white because it is such a nice opaque white. And again, you can mix it with any color to lighten them up. Another shade I use a lot is M802, which is a gorgeous coral. So it's just a gorgeous coral shade. And I use the yellow one quite a bit as well. And yellow can be a hard paint to get pigmented, so this is a super bright, intense yellow. I'm obsessed with it. Another favorite product of mine when I'm doing metallic looks is the metallic powders from Mayron. This is the one in silver, and these last such a long time because you just need a tiny amount. I will usually put a little bit in a dish and then mix it up with some water and then apply it to the face that way. And these are just super, super intense. I also have the gold one as well, but I can't find it at the moment. I'm just gonna swatch this for you guys so you can see how intense it is. So it's just a super high shine, crazy metallic pigment, and it's really, really easy to work with too. So that is one of my favorites. Also, Makeup Forever has some amazing metallic powders too. This one is in Metal Powder, just number 1. And I love, love, love this one when I'm doing gold looks. And then just apply it with a brush. So it has a super metallic finish, and it's just beautiful. And I like using those a lot of the time as lip toppers or even shadows. So another thing that is a must-have for me doing body painting is bright colored pigments and eyeshadows. You guys probably know Sugar Pill is like my go-to brand for bright colored eyeshadows. I also love their pigments as well. You can mix them with a mixing medium or even just water, or just apply them dry, and they're so beautiful. Of course, you guys know I love their eyeshadows as well. This is my pro palette from them. As you can see, I'm running low on a lot of these colors, so I need to refill cut quite a few of them, but yeah, this is just a must-have for me. I love using bright colored eyeshadows to contour and just to shade and add detail. And if you're looking for bright eyeshadows for creative looks with a bit of a better price point, the NYX Ultimate Shadow Palette in Brights is great. I have gone through a couple of these. I love them so much. There is quite a good variety of colors in here, brights, and then also a couple more pastel shades as well. I love using these for shading in a lot of my looks, so yeah, I totally recommend this palette. Another Makeup Forever product that I love is the Color Cream. So these are a gel-based face and body color. This is great because they come in a really big size tube, so you can cover a lot of area with these guys. And since they are a gel, they feel very lightweight on the skin. So this one is M802. And then this one is actually my favorite. This is the red in M704. So M704. Of course, a must-have product for me for creative looks is glitter. I mean, what would I do without glitter? A couple of my favorite glitter brands. These are from the Shine Shack. The Shine Shack has a lot of really cool textured glitters, glitters that have different sizes and chunky glitters. So if you're looking for some really cool glitters that stand out, totally check out the Shine Shack. I'll have them linked down below. The same with Go Get Glitter. They have a ton of chunky glitters of a lot of different colors. And if you're looking for beautiful glitters that are more fine, totally check out Lit Cosmetics. I do have a discount code with them as well. I will have that link down below in case you want to check out some of their glitters. This is one of my favorite. This is Cayman in size number 3. It's just a beautiful deep turquoise color. And yeah, these are amazing. I like to use them with the Lit Cosmetics glitter base or even Go Get Glitter. They sell a great glitter base as well. And NYX has a great glitter glue, so yeah, those are a couple of my favorite glitters. Okay, so I also get a lot of questions where I get my extra little bits and pieces and stuff that I like to glue on my face. So usually 90% of the time, they are from Michael's Craft Store. They have a ton of gems and jewels and just all kinds of things that you can stick on your face. I get lots of chunky glitters from there too. Just be careful using these around the eye area. They are not eye safe, but for any other part of the face, I totally recommend these. They come in all kinds of colors. Michael's also has a ton of really beautiful paper flowers. These are a couple of my favorites. So yeah, if you ever need inspiration, check out Michael's Craft Store because they have a ton of cool stuff that might inspire you to glue to your face and to create a makeup kind of base around. That's what I do a lot of the time when I am lacking inspiration. Also the dollar store. You'd be surprised what kind of cool shit you can find at the dollar store. It might surprise you. So if you're ever just feeling low on inspiration, just kind of walk through the aisles and see what kind of stuff you can find. I also wanted to give an honorable mention to liquid lipsticks. I use these for all kinds of things when I'm doing body painting. I will use them sometimes for contouring or for my eyes, like eyeshadow or just detail work. If I can't find the color that I want in paint, sometimes I will look for a liquid lipstick. Just be careful since some of these colors aren't eye safe. Yeah, just use caution when using these since they are meant for the lips, not the eyes, but I have used them all over my face without any kind of irritation. And some of my favorites are from NYX, Sugar Pill, Lime Crime. So yeah, any bold color liquid lipsticks I have probably used all over my face. And I love it because it dries down. It's not going to smudge everywhere. So if you want to do some detailed work and you don't have a face paint, well, a liquid lipstick is a great option. And a couple more products I wanted to mention are the Primal Colors from NYX. These are a great, good priced, bold eyeshadow. You can use these all over the face. I used these a ton when I was competing in the Face Awards. And yeah, they have a lot of super bold colors, so I love these guys. I also love the Vivid Bright Cream Color from NYX. These are a great base underneath eyeshadow, but I use them all over my face. They're really creamy, they have a bunch of cool colors, so definitely check these out. NYX has a bunch of great things you can use for body painting that come at a reasonable price. So yeah, you can't really go wrong there. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this little video. Just wanted to talk about a couple products that I love. If you have any questions or if you want to see any videos on different techniques for body painting, just let me know down below. I can definitely do that for you guys. So yeah, thank you so much for watching and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.